Scholastic Audio presents Secrets of a Lab Rat, Book 2. Mom, There's a Dinosaur in Beeson's Lake by Trudi Trueit. Read by Oliver Wyman. Chapter 1. Big Trouble at Little Creek. Everyone's already in the water, Scab. My mom is standing outside the boys' locker room at the Little Creek Swim Club. I am standing in it. Scab, are you in there? No. Oops. Your class is starting. I don't care. You'll care plenty when you're stuck on land this summer. Bug spit. Why did I make that dumb promise? I hate swimming, and I really hate swimming lessons. So why did I promise to take another session if my parents would let me go sturgeon fishing with Uncle Aunt? Easy. I'd have said anything to get them to say yes to the fishing trip. You don't want to fall off your uncle's boat and drown because you didn't practice treading, my mother calls. Her voice ping-pongs off the tiles. You don't want to drown, do you? I take a long look at myself in the mirror. Scab, I'm thinking it over. I'm sure it isn't that bad, Squiggle Bear. I shiver, and not just because she called me that nickname loud enough for the whole pool to hear. I look stupid, Mom. If you would have come to the mall with Isabel and me. Shopping with my mother and twin sister is the worst torture ever. This is how it works. Isabel takes a bunch of clothes into the dressing room. After a while, she runs out crying, "Everything is so ugly." That's when I say, "Maybe it's not the clothes," and get nailed with a hanger. Why do girls get so pruny over clothes anyway? I don't care what I wear, as long as it's dark blue. Dark blue trash bag? Okay by me. Scab's tip number 22. While waiting for your mom to shop, take all the clothes off the dummies. Pose the dummies so they are saluting the people that come off the escalator. Score bonus points. Stand next to the naked dummies and salute too while humming the Battle Hymn of the Republic. Do they fit, Scab? Yeah, but then come on. We'll work it out later. Scab's tip number 23. Keep your clothes on during tip number 22, or the security guard won't let you back in the mall for a long time. Trust me. Doesn't she get it? Look at me. Just look at me. No, don't. It's too embarrassing. Let me wrap up in my dark blue beach towel. Okay, now you can look. I know, I've got skinny arms, but they can move fast if Lewis Pigford even thinks about snagging my double fudge brownie at lunch. My legs are covered in bruises and scrapes from my daredevil stunts. See that patch of skin missing from my left knee? I did that on the Mighty Maze, the obstacle course that Doyle, Will Greenleaf, and I set up in my backyard. I was a human rocket. After blastoff, I zigzagged through 6 stacks of paint cans, snake slithered on my belly under the big tarp, and flew across the croc-infested water trap without so much as dipping a toe into water. Okay, there weren't really any crocs in the kiddie pool. Once I scrambled over Joe's doghouse, however, I ran into trouble. Namely, Joe. My yellow Labrador grabbed my foot. As usual, Joe wanted to play. I wanted to finish. I did better on my second try. I set a new world record time of 22.5 seconds. I am the Mighty Maze King. But that was yesterday. 19.5 hours ago. Forever ago. My best friend, Doyle Ferguson, peers around the corner into the locker room. He's dripping wet. You coming out this century, Scab, or not? He's talking loudly, which means my mother sent him in here after me. I hold my towel tighter. Not, Cool by me, he says in a normal voice. He yanks on the string of his black swim trunks. Plain black trunks. Lucky guy. Give me a sec to make it look like I tried to talk you out, says Doyle. Then I'll tell Ashlyn. Who? Our swim teacher. She's in high school. He grins. High school. It's going to take a lot more than a cute older girl to get me out there. I'll tell Ashlyn you're afraid of the water. I'm not, I say. I can swim better than anybody out there. Even me? Even you. And he knows it, too. Even your sister? We both know nobody does anything better than Isabel. I puff out my chest. Especially her. Prove it. I watch myself deflate. I'd rather not. Are you kidding? The guy who flew 10 feet 9 inches over Alex's super colossal dirt bike ramp? The guy who burned through the mighty maze in 23 seconds? The guy who ate a wad of dryer lint? Top secret. Scab's personal 411. Enter password. Access denied. Enter password. Access denied. Enter password. I'll let it go this time. Access granted. Scab's fears. Fear? Deep water. Why? I can't touch bottom. Fear? Enchiladas. Why? I don't trust food that's folded. Who knows what it's hiding? Fear? Automatic sliding doors. Why? Squish-o-matic your kid at the food mart. Have a nice day. Fear? The letter G. Why? I can't write it in cursive. My teacher, Miss Sweet and Sour, says my G's are saggy. So are her ears. Fear? Ferns. Why? Freaky branches? Curly tendrils? Spores? Hello, alien species! Fear? Getting lost. Why? I'd miss my dog, Joe, my friends, and my family. Even Tattletale Isabel. 22.5 seconds, I correct. And I'm telling you, I can't go out there. Why not? Because. Because why? Are you a fraidy cat? No. I am starting to feel warm. Then why? Meow, meow. Just because. I grit my teeth. Meow, meow. He sounds like Will's cat, Mayonnaise, before they got him fixed. The cat, I mean, not Will. Doyle holds his arms up and lets his wrists go limp like paws. He claws the air. Meow, meow. Why, Scab? Because. Why? Me? Because this. I let go of the towel. Yow. Doyle's jaw drops. He cannot believe it. He wipes his eyes, but we both know there is nothing wrong with his vision. It is me. It is all me. I am wearing school bus yellow swim trunks, covered in, I can hardly say it, squirrels. From my stomach to my knees, there's nothing but squirrels. Big squirrels and little squirrels, gray squirrels and red squirrels, fat squirrels and skinny squirrels, boy squirrels and girl squirrels. Each squirrel has a fluffy tail. Each squirrel is holding a big acorn. It gets worse. Much worse. Doyle lowers his fake paws. Are they? Yeah, I moan. They're dancing. Some of the squirrels are wearing tuxedos and tap dancing. Others are swaying in hula skirts. A few aren't wearing anything. I know my sister was involved in this. She probably told my mother squirrels were the newest thing in swim trunks. And by now, Tattletale Isabel has probably gossiped to everyone out there, including Ashlyn, that I am wearing this ridiculous suit. My class is waiting for me to come out so they can laugh it up. But I'm not going out. No way. No how. No chance. Doyle? Scab? What's going on in there?
Your mom, croaks Doyle.
Boys, let's go.
What do we do?
Our heads swivel between the front door and the pool entrance. The front door, the pool entrance, the front...
Salvatore Wallingford McNally, are you coming out or do I have to come in?
No!
That's all I need. For every kid at River Rock Elementary to know that my mother marched into the boys' locker room at the Little Creek Swim Club and hauled me out to the pool by the seat of my squirrel print swim trunks.
I'm coming out,
I cry. Doyle gasps. If I want to go fishing with Uncle Ant, I've got no other choice, I remind him. I take a deep breath. This is for the fish.
For the fish, he says.
We knock knuckles. Doyle slaps me on the back.
You're the bravest kid in the universe, Scab.
I nod, though I know it isn't true. If I'm lucky, Doyle will never know how close he came to guessing the truth, that I am a fraidy cat after all. I clench my teeth. I clench my fists. I clench my dancing squirrel butt, and I take the longest walk of my short life. Chapter 2. Warning. Squirrel Crossing. Doyle and I rush past a sign that says, "No running," as fast as we can without running. He waves to a dark-haired older girl standing in the shallow end of the pool. That must be Ashlyn. I don't wave. I have a plan. My beach towel is wrapped around my waist so tightly it's digging into my skin. Our class is in the water. They are lined up along the edge of the pool, practicing the scissors kick. 7 pairs of eyes, including my sister's, follow us. I fling off my towel, squat, and hop in the water. Ha! 2 seconds tops. Nobody could have possibly seen...
Nice squirrels, McNally, hoots Lewis Pigford.
Everyone snickers, except my sister. She looks away.
I knew it, Isabel tattled. My twin is forever telling people about the stuff I do, the stuff I don't do, and the stuff she thinks I should do.
We just turned 10 years old, but I am in the 4th grade and she is in the 5th. Isabel got moved ahead this year because she is smart times 10. I wish Isabel would get moved ahead in swim class, too. That way, I wouldn't have to worry about her reporting back to our parents every single thing I do, don't do, or should do in the water. Scab's Pool Time Fun. Have a contest to see who can make the biggest fart bubble in the pool. Hint, eat a bowl of super spicy chili 4 hours before you go swimming and you'll win every time. Tell your sister you threw a quarter in the pool. Tell her if she finds it, she can keep it. A half hour later, when she says she has searched every inch of the pool and can't find the quarter, gasp and say, "Quarter? Did I say quarter? I meant rock." During the lap swim time, swim in circles. When the lifeguard shouts at you to do laps like everyone else, yell back that you can't swim in a straight line because one arm is shorter than the other. Did you know the human body is made up of 80% water? While in the pool, go up to a second grader and tell him this fact, then clutch your stomach and scream,
"Go get help! I'm leaking!"
This pool is freezing, says Doyle as we kick.
We hope you enjoyed this preview.
To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.